Imagine you have a massive games database, thousands of roles, hundreds of developers, and you just want to pull a handful of classic studios like Bullfrog, Westwood, or Ensemble. Manually ticking checkboxes? Painful and tedious. Instead, Power Query gives us smarter ways. Today, we'll explore four different ways to filter by a list, each with its own strengths and weaknesses. We'll use a games table with a developer column. Let's start. First, download both tables, data and filter list, into Power Query. I will create a new query for each method. Let's start. Select the data query and click Merge Queries in the Home tab. Now, select the corresponding columns, developer and list. The trick here is to use right outer join, which keeps matching only rows. Now Power Query shows only games from our filter list. This method is very visual. You see the match happening and no code needed. It's great for beginners, and it's also pretty fast. The major downside here is that this method is pretty limited. You can only use it for exact text match only. For the second method, we will use List.Contains function. It checks whether a value exists inside a list. In our case, we want to check if the developer in each row of the data table exists in our filter list. If yes, keep the row. If no, remove it. Our filter list is a table with one column, called list. Power Query can't directly use a table in list contains. It needs a list. So you can just type the column name in square brackets after the query name. As you can see, table select rows iterates through every row in the games table. Each is shorthand for this row. Developer refers to the current row's developer value, and list contains returns true if developer is in the list, false otherwise. So only rows where the developer exists in the list remain. If you don't want to bother with this, you can drill down the filter list column and use the list. It's clean and minimal, no merging, no extra columns. It's pretty reusable, efficient and flexible. It will work much slower than the previous method, but it's more flexible. By the way, make sure that your filter list doesn't contain duplicates. Also, if you want to handle case sensitivity, let me know in the comments and I'll do a new video for this. But what if your condition is much more complex? You can combine this method with any conditions you like. Let's get a little more advanced and only show games created by developers from our filter list and released after 1995. So just add end date year, release date greater than 1995. And that's all. You can stack multiple conditions like filtering by developer and year or anything else. It's powerful when your filtering logic needs to be very specific. But keep in mind, the flexibility comes with a cost. The more criteria you use, the longer you will have to wait. And the last method for today, partial match with text contains. Sometimes your filter list isn't exact. Maybe it just contains fragments like black, white, red, or anything other. You want any developer containing those words. So I'll show you this little neat trick. Table select rows iterates over every row of the game's table. List transform loops through each keyword in the filter list and checks if developer contains said keyword. It returns a list of true or false values. List any true checks if any of the true false values is true. If yes, keep 0. If all false, remove 0. Essentially, keep the 0 if it matches any keyword in our list. So partial or fuzzy matches are perfect if you don't have exact names. Case insensitive matching can be used here too. Works with compare ordinal ignore case. It's very flexible, you can combine it with other conditions, and it works with fragments. Great when your list only has parts of names. As you can see, this formula is a bit more complex. So you will need to learn some M code. Beginners may find it harder to read, but it isn't something to be afraid of. Keep in mind the performance issues. Looping over a big table and a big list can be slower than exact matches method. And think about overmatching. Small fragments can match too many rows. Like the word red can be found in other words. So all four methods solve the same problem, filtering by a list, but each shines in different scenarios. Experiment, mix them, and see what fits your data best. See ya!